Let's take a quick trip back to high school science. Ears are amazing and sensitive things. Three main sections: outer ear, middle ear, and inner ear. Sound is vibrations in air. The outer ear, the part you can see, collects those vibrations and funnels them into the ear canal. That's the part of the ear you should never jam a Q-tip into. Who knew? Those good vibrations hit your eardrum in the middle ear. And when the eardrum vibrates, it moves three very tiny little bones. And those bones help amplify the vibrations around you and transmit them to the inner ear. In the inner ear, we have the cochlea. It's a snail shell-shaped chamber filled with fluids and tiny hair cells. The tiny bones in the middle ear vibrate the fluid in the inner ear and stimulate the hair cells in the cochlea. Those hair cells in the cochlea are tuned to hear different frequencies of sound. And when a hair cell is stimulated, it sends a pulse along the auditory nerve and into your brain. Your brain interprets those impulses, it makes sense of them, and that's how we arrive at audio we can understand. As a quick aside, what's fascinating in modern society, the tools we've made to create content attempt to replicate this system. Microphones have a diaphragm which is sensitive to vibrations in air. Instead of tiny bones, fluid, and hair cells, we can use magnets to convert those vibrations, and wiggling magnets creates tiny electrical pulses, which are then sent over cables to some kind of storage and analysis brain, like a computer. Your ears are a remarkable adaptation, a detailed, sensitive system which can capture, analyze, and process an incredible amount of information in real time. It makes the audio lag on Bluetooth headphones seem quaint. But since the ear is this sensitive, it's also very fragile. In modern society, when we're surrounded by noise and amplifying our media, it doesn't take much to damage these tiny little bits. And once damaged, your ear never fully recovers. Not only should we try to protect our hearing, I think we should try to feed these amazing instruments better quality content too. Just a thought. As always, thanks so much for watching, for sharing these videos, and subscribing to this channel. 2020 Hearing is an ongoing project where we'll chat even more about hearing health and improving our audio content quality. It's also a fun play on the year and 2020 vision. It's a thing, it's kind of a pun. There's plenty more to come, including guides on headphones, earbuds, and ear tips, proper fit for earplugs, interviews with manufacturers and doctors, and also some room for answering your own questions about hearing health and hearing loss. If you would like to help support the production of these conversations, because we know YouTube analytics, they're not gonna help get that job done, there are links down below, and you might consider joining the list of names scrolling by on your screen. It's a growing community of fun, like-minded tech pals, a huge resource for me as I'm planning future video topics, and they're just generally super cool folks. I hope you'll check them out. Now, you know where you can find me around the rest of the internet, at SomeGadgetGuy on the Twitters and the Twitch, and the Facebooks and the Instagrams, and I will catch you all on the next video.